If you're serious about TIG welding, you may be looking for a machine that has a pulse setting, which is a feature that really makes this unit stand out. This digital TIG has both AC and DC pulse settings. Remember, DC is for welding steel and AC is for welding aluminum. This feature allows you to control the arc by fluctuating the amperage up and down. If you watch someone TIG weld and they're repeatedly moving the pedal up and down at a steady pace, they're basically doing their own pulse. You can program this digital TIG to do this for you automatically with exact precision. You're able to control the minimum and maximum amperage, along with how frequently and how long the pulse takes place. This is useful when you're welding thin material where you want to minimize distortion, prevent blow through, or focus an arc on the edge of a piece of metal. It's also great for precision work like roll cages. It allows you to precisely dial in the machine and use the torch trigger rather than continually working the foot pedal to control the amperage. But you can still use the foot pedal, which is nice when you need less heat, like if you're getting near the end of a piece of metal and it's getting hot, you can let off the pedal to lower the amperage. This TIG really makes it easy to program because it's easy to understand since you can see the settings as a chart rather than a bunch of individual knobs. Let's show you how easy it is to program pulse. To set pulse for welding steel, select DC TIG. Then select your other standard parameters like preflow, high frequency start, and torch control. Now set the starting amperage and upslope time. We'll set the peak amperage and pulse percentage, which is what the pulse feature will perfectly control. With DC pulse, you'll now set the pulse frequency and pulse ratio. The pulse frequency is how often per second this pattern happens. So if you set it to 1, this pattern will happen 1 time each second. Pulse ratio is the ratio of the peak amperage to the minimum amperage. So if you set it at 80%, it will be at the peak 80% of the time, and then the lower amperage 20%. Or 8/10 of a second on peak, then 2/10 of a second on the lower amperage, and then it will repeat the cycle. Finally, program your standard ending settings like post flow, which only occur when you release the trigger or let off the foot pedal. With everything set, you're ready to weld. Through the lens, you can actually see the pulse feature in action as the metal is welded, giving you that look of stacked dimes everyone wants. In AC mode, you also have the ability to set AC frequency and AC bounce. Basically, this is going to allow you to control the arc shape, penetration, and cleaning when welding aluminum. The digital TIG also has mixed pulse. In many cases while welding aluminum with low amperages, the arc can be difficult to stabilize. So this machine adds a DC pulse while welding to do just that, stabilize your arc. As you can see, the Eastwood TIG 200 Digital has all the features you not only want, but need in a quality machine. Plus a rocker style foot pedal and WP17 flex head torch, as well as the ability to weld steel and aluminum up to 1/4 inch. And don't forget the Eastwood 3-year warranty and money back guarantee. And Eastwood has a bunch of videos on YouTube that teach beginners, as well as videos that show advanced techniques, making learning the TIG weld easier than ever. For more information or to get your welder today, click the button to visit eastwood.com.